Ahoy, this is Azinka. This is Hover Air X1 flying selfie stick I introduced on my channel a while ago. Anybody can fly this. No GPS required. It's all AI powered. It takes off and lands from your hand. Today, let's go through advanced features and settings when it comes to getting the best selfie shots on the go. This video is sponsored by Epidemic Sound. Let's jump straight into Orbit Shot. If you are going to be using only default settings on this camera, you are going to miss out on much nicer creative angles. That was just a very standard, basic, flat orbit shot. Let's go through settings and change a few things here. First of all, you can change the radius between 1.5, 2.5, 4, and 6 meters. If you want to show off the location you are at, increase the radius to 4 or 6 meters. If you want the focus to be on you, go with 1.5 or 2.5 meters. Let's talk about the altitude. The nicest view, sort of a hero shot, you will get if you select lower 1 meter. If you want to achieve a shot which looks like a typical drone shot, select rise 1 meter. You can use the clips separately, or you can combine them together just like this. Zoom out shot is next. If you are going to select just a short distance and a very flat standard shot, the result will be just okay. How can we make it better? Look at the difference you are going to get if you increase the distance to 9 meters and change the altitude to rise. You are going to reveal this beautiful tree, giving the shot a more interesting view. Or here in this shot, suddenly seeing the whole scenery changes the shot completely. This is very suitable if you're gonna be standing under the tree or gazebo or in front of a nice house. Another variation of the same shot with similar effect is selecting lower altitude instead. The shot will reveal what is above you, but you will still be the main focus of the shot. The opposite would be the next shot, the zoom in shot. And the same thing as before. If you are just going to select the short distance and a flat standard shot, it's just going to be okay. You're not going to get much of an effect. The nicest shot, in my opinion, is if you go with a lower altitude and 9 meters distance. In this shot, watch the roof changing its shape, giving a nice revealing effect. On the other hand, if you select higher altitude, you will get a perfect shot for opening a new scene, establishing a location. Here is a perfect opportunity to cut it into a close-up talking headshot. Bird's eye shot by default will be just a rise shot from a nearby distance. The camera is not gonna be that high. On top of it, there is nothing interesting about the shot as the location is boring. There are a few things you can do to make it a lot more interesting and dynamic. First of all, don't choose just a plain ground, but look for interesting shapes. Big circle or lines. Imagine how the view is going to look from above. Selecting the right location will make a big difference. Select 15 meters altitude and edge spin. You can choose between slow, standard, and fast spin. This effect works very well for this location with straight lines. Even this location looks interesting from above. The key is to pick the right location. This effect will get even better if you add cinematic music and ambient natural sounds, as these drones don't record natural ambient sounds. However, this one can record your voice through your smartphone. To find suitable music is super easy with royalty-free music service Epidemic Sound, as they added a feature where you can find the music video. You can upload your clip and then choose one of these suggested songs. The music and sound effects are also nicely organized in two categories. With Epidemic Sound, you will avoid all copyright claims on YouTube or your other social media. I've been using them for a number of years, and what I really like is that you can download the whole song and also stems. If you need only drums or melody, it is all here. They also have an app for the phone. You'll find a link to get a free 30-day trial below the video in the video description. Thank you very much, Epidemic Sound, for making this video possible. Follow mode doesn't have to be a standard follow shot at eye level. Here is a standard shot in vertical mode. They just added that feature last week. You can select 1 meter above to be able to show off the location as well. The view will be a typical shot you see with drones. And the shot will look very nice if you select far distance. If you need a standard distance shot, you're going to get a view like this. And you can also select 1 meter lower altitude. This shot is great if you have a large open space with lots of sky ahead. And here is a bad example of what not to do, what to avoid. The dark hair is getting lost in all these tree crowns. The background is way too busy. Some of you asked if the drone is fast enough to follow someone who is riding on a bike. Yes, it certainly can. The faster you will go, the more distance the drone is going to keep away from you. It can also change direction and the drone will follow up. Keep in mind, for those who love water sports, that you cannot fly the drone over the water. Just in case you're wondering. Dolly track shot can be enabled under custom mode. This is when you will follow the drone. Keep in mind that the shot must be in a straight line. If you change the direction, the hover camera is going to lose you. Let's change the altitude once again. Instead of this regular flat altitude typical shot, experiment with lower altitude or higher altitude to show more of a location. This camera is primarily a selfie camera, but if you happen to be in a beautiful, stunning location, you can grab one or two shots from above if you fly it in manual mode and use your smartphone as a joystick. Keep in mind though that the drone needs to be very close to your smartphone as you will be using Wi-Fi to see a shot preview. You can also change the camera angle. Here again, you will need to walk with the drone either forward or sideways in order to stay connected. I wanted to see how high I could get the drone. I cannot recall how high the drone was, but I lost connection, which I regained in about a minute, so I was able to land the drone safely. Bottom line, if you're after aerial shots and you want really, really big shots when you send the drone away, get a bigger drone. This is just a selfie drone. All right, let's add those clips together, add some music and sound effects and transitions. Let's recap all those shots. By the way, the final edit was done in CapCut. If you want to learn how to do basic and advanced editing in CapCut, don't forget to subscribe as this tutorial is coming up very soon. Give it a thumbs up and let me know in the comment section below if you own a drone, which one do you own, or if you have a Hover Air, and let me know how you like it. By the way, don't forget to check out one of these videos next. See you in the next one. Ciao. Ahoy.